Next, we shall do some problems related to this fundamental theorem of calculus. First problem is find the derivative of f of x is equal to integral minus 1 to x 1 divided by 1 plus t square dt. So remember, what is fundamental theorem of calculus? If f of x is equal to integral a to x small f of t dt, then capital F dash x is the value of the integrand at the upper limit. This is fundamental theorem of calculus version 1. So this lower limit, that is irrelevant. Derivative of f of x is the value of the integrand at the upper limit. So what is f dash x? According to this fundamental theorem of calculus formula, it is integrand evaluated at the upper limit. That means 1 divided by 1 plus x square. So this is the answer. Now second problem is, let g of x is equal to integral x to 3 square root of 1 plus t square dt. We want to find g dash x, but here the lower limit is x, upper limit is 3. We have to put it the other way around. Upper limit should be x and lower limit must be some constant. So by property of integrals, this is integral minus 3 to x square root of 1 plus t square dt. So now we can directly apply fundamental theorem of calculus version 1 and obtain the derivative of g as g dash x is equal to the value of the integrand at the upper limit square root of 1 plus x square. That's it. Next example is, if y is equal to integral 0 to x cube cos t square dt, then compute dy by dx. So look at the upper limit, it is x cube, it's not x. So you cannot directly apply fundamental theorem of calculus. So what we will do, we shall put u is equal to x cube. So put u equal to x cube. Then what is y? Integral 0 to u cos t square dt. Now we shall compute dy by dx, but dy by dx you cannot compute, but you can compute dy by du. But dy by dx is dy by du into du by dx. So this is known as chain rule. So dy by du is value of the integrand at the upper limit u. So it is cos u square into du by dx. What is du by dx? It is 3x square. This is equal to, look at u. This variable we have introduced. In the given problem, there is no u. So write u in terms of x. U equal to x cube. So u square is x to the power 6. So this is cos x to the power 6 into 3x square. So this is 3x square cos x to the power 6. This is the answer. Another problem. Okay, first we'll make a remark. So remark, the fundamental theorem of calculus gives ये मेथड टू फाइंड एन एंटी डेरिवेटिव, कैपिटल एफ ऑफ ए गिवन फंक्शन स्मॉल एफ. So what is meant by antiderivative? You have learned it. So we are given a function small f. An antiderivative of small f is another function, let us say capital F, whose derivative is small f. So antiderivative means a function capital F whose derivative is the given function small f. The fundamental theorem of calculus precisely gives a method to find antiderivative of a continuous function, given continuous function. Continuity of f is required, because in the proof of fundamental theorem of calculus, we are essentially using the fact that the given function small f is continuous. And what was the construction of capital F? Capital F was constructed as the area from A to X of the curve small f of t. So, example, find an antiderivative of f of x, small f of x is equal to x square. So this is my continuous function, f of x is equal to x square. We want to construct an antiderivative using fundamental theorem of calculus. So capital F of x is given by integral, lower limit is anything, let us say a to x small f of t dt, so t square dt. ഇത്ര മാത്രമേ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എഴുതാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ തൽക്കാലം. ഇതിൻ്റെ വാല്യൂ എന്താണെന്ന് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇപ്പോൾ അറിഞ്ഞുകൂടാ. സോ ദിസ് ആൻഡ് എഫ് ഡാഷ് എക്സ് വിൽ ബി ദ വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് ദ ഇൻറ്റഗ്രാൻഡ് അറ്റ് ദ അപ്പർ ലിമിറ്റ്, നെയ്മ്ലി എഫ് ഡാഷ് എക്സ് വിൽ ബി ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എക്സ് വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് ദി ഇൻറ്റഗ്രാൻഡ് അറ്റ് ദി അപ്പർ ലിമിറ്റ് എക്സ് സ്ക്വയർ. സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് ആൻ ആൻറ്റി ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ്. If you put a different number in the lower limit, you will get another antiderivative. So there are so many antiderivatives, not only one. For each value in the lower limit, you will get an antiderivative. We shall do one more example.